In this video, we're going to talk about the transform tool in Forger. This tool allows translation, rotation, and scaling of entire meshes or parts of them. The transform tool has three modes: translation, rotation, and scale. In the translation mode, dragging from the different axis handles will apply the same axis translation to the unmasked areas of the mesh. Doing so from the central handle will translate along the view plane. In the rotation mode, dragging from the different axis circles will apply the same rotation to the unmasked areas of the mesh. Similarly, doing so from the external circle will rotate along the view plane. In the scaling mode, dragging from the different axis handles will apply the scale along the different axis. Doing so from the central one will apply a uniform scale. As mentioned before, using these tools with unmasked meshes will affect the entire mesh, but if part of a mesh is masked, it will only affect unmasked vertices. Sometimes it's useful to adjust the pivot point so that it's placed exactly where we need it to. This can be done by pressing the alternate shortcut whilst using the manipulators. As long as the shortcut is pressed, the transformations applied to the manipulators will not be applied to the mesh. There is another way of adjusting the manipulator's pivot point, and that is by using the masking shortcut. If the masking shortcut is pressed, and we touch on the selected mesh, the manipulator will snap to it. Then, without releasing the masking shortcut, nor our viewport input, we can adjust the direction of the axis. If we press the smooth shortcut while we're adjusting the direction of the axis, the manipulator will snap to the closest 90-degree angle. While snapping the manipulator, this masking shortcut-based action will also create a topological symmetry mask if it finds a valid loop at the origin. This can be useful especially for meshes that have a good topological flow, as it can help pose them. If further pivot tweaks are needed, so the pivot isn't lying exactly on the surface, one can always use the alternate shortcut as mentioned before to do further adjustments. It is sometimes useful to mirror the manipulator to see things from the other side. The Mirror Gizmo button allows us to do so. Finally, in the tool panel, we can see that there are some extra options and buttons that will allow us to choose whether the masking snapping alignment mode is set to normal or the view, to ignore symmetry, or center the pivot in various ways.